All right, folks, it's range day. I'm out here testing a few different arrow lengths because arrow length seems like one of those things that people just give a standard number and go with it. But is there actually an optimal arrow length for your bow setup? There has to be, right? So I'm here to test out a few different lengths, but the idea behind what I'm going to be trying to find is the arrow length that puts the arrow node on my rest when I'm at full draw. So I'm gonna grab this arrow here and demonstrate. So here we have a 29-inch arrow. And as I flex this arrow, the arrow will flex in the middle portion of the shaft. There are two points on a shaft that have minimal flex. Those are your arrow nodes. There's one in the back and there's one in the front. You're gonna have a little bit more flex up in the in front of the node, a little bit of flex behind the node, in the middle between the nodes, all your flex action is going to be happening. So you want the node of the arrow, wherever that is, to sit on your rest when you're at full draw, because as the arrow, as the power stroke of the bow is putting force or work on the arrow is flexing. So if you have the bow held and you're solid and the arrow releases and the arrow starts to flex, the point at which the arrow is the straightest and has the least amount of flex is going to deviate the least amount when the bow is released. So if you have that rest on a portion of this arrow that the arrow is going to flex a lot, if your grip is torqued or your anchor point's off, the arrow is released a different way or the string is twisted a little bit and the arrow reacts differently to the power stroke, that flex is going to throw your shot off a lot more than if it was in the spot where it's not going to flex. So that's kind of the idea of why you want the arrow to be sitting on the node. It's just gonna be a lot more forgiving for you downrange. When it comes to choosing a starting point, I like to start at my draw length, and my draw length's 27.5 inches. I have this arrow cut carbon to carbon, 27.5 inches. So that's gonna be my starting point to based off of where my rest is on my node, I'll either go longer or shorter. So let me draw this back, see if it's on my node, and then I'll show you the second way to find the node, which to me is a little bit more effective. So as you can see when I draw back here, that my arrow is just sitting on the back of the node, which ideally you'd want it centered in the node. If you have a spot on the arrow, you want it to be right on that spot, because these arrows have a position or an area, I want that node to be in the center. So I'd actually have to shorten my arrow length up about 1/4 inch to get that node rested right. Real quick, I just have a couple quick notes to make about changing or manipulating your arrow node. And a really quick point to make is that your arrow node may change its position when you switch from a field tip to a broadhead. So if the broadhead is a lot longer than your field point, the center of gravity is going to change and your node can change its position based on the length of your broadhead. Number two, you can manipulate the node of your arrow a little bit by either adding or subtracting point weight. Now, if you go from 100 to 125 grains or from 100 grains to 75 grains, the change might be minimal. But if you're adding 50, 75, 100 grains or subtracting that much, it might be enough to not have to cut your arrow to a different length to get that node centered on your rest. So let's discuss how to find your node in a different manner. So this way is pretty simple. You grab the arrow on the nock and you need a hard surface. A wooden table or something works pretty well. You just grab them lightly on the back of the arrow, start further up on the arrow and then work your way down. You can really tell the difference. And the idea is that you want to bounce the arrow on the hard surface and in the position where the arrow is dead, you're on the node. So you can see that I'm getting less vibration as I move down. You can see that it's dead. So bounce, that's the node right there. No bounce. So I'd mark that position. You can see the difference there. Bounce, 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 dead. So as that happens, you just mark that spot on your arrow, draw back and make sure that the arrow is sitting on the node, and that's gonna be the optimal length of arrow for your setup.